Tonight is July the 20th, 2020. And what I'm going to do tonight is make a short video so that you ladies and gentlemen out there can hear music from these amplifiers that I build that a lot of you ask for. So we will listen to this amplifier here. This is a stereo version. It's a Williamson design. It uses KT66s in the output and the Acrosound TO-300 transformers. The other amplifier is going to be the same design, pretty much component for component, except that the output transformers in the next stereo amplifier that we'll be comparing this one to, this one compared to the other one, will be the UTC LS-57 transformers. Now, I don't know if there's actually two camps out there. I don't think so. Differing between Acrosound transformers and UTC transformers, I think the consensus is they both are excellent transformers. They're vintage. They probably were made in the 50s or early 60s, maybe up to the 70s. I think if you look at a 1970 UTC transformer, they still made the LS57, and they probably still made this Acrosound transformer too. But anyway, this is a pair of Acrosound, KT66 Williamson design, and what we're going to be listening to it through. We'll be playing a CD through this Macintosh CD player right here, and that feeds into this MX-113 Mac preamp tuner here, which drives the amplifier, and the amplifier is driving these Dahlquist, as you can see the name down there. Make sure it focuses. Dahlquist speakers are called DQ20s. They're a 10-inch bass, I think about a 5-inch mid, and maybe a 2-inch tweeter, left channel and right channel. Mostly we're going to be looking at the back of my monitor and clutter here, but I'll be showing you on a general radio sound level meter, the sound pressure level, and we're going to be listening to this music right here, just the very first one. Very nice, really clean sounding recording, and I hope you like it. We'll listen to it on this one, on this amplifier, and then we'll listen to it a second time on the next amplifier. Okay, now I want to make sure this stays in focus, so this is really important. This is the general radio sound level meter. We'll be monitoring it. We'll be looking at it sometimes. So like I said, we're not just looking at the back of that monitor. And I'll show you how quiet it is in here. Got to turn it on. Okay. Well, I've got it set on 50 dB. Okay, I want it to stay focused. Can't get it too close. 50 dB is the zero mark. Whatever this is, the zero mark is there, and then it's plus 10 or minus 10. So it looks like it's running about 45 dB sound pressure level here. Pretty quiet. I've got everything off, even down to unplugging the refrigerator so it won't turn on. Okay, let's start it out at about on the 70 dB scale. So this would be 70, this would be 80. If it's a 70, this would be 60. So you'll see how it plays out here. And I'll keep holding this up from time to time so we can see what the sound pressure level is. See, with me talking, it's actually going up to about 80. 70, I'm sorry. Zero in here would be 70 dB. So it's really quiet in here. And when I quit talking, I think about the only thing we can hear is the maybe the fans in the computer or something. So let's listen to some music. Okay, now we're going to do the Williamson designed with the LS-57 transformers. Exact same design, slightly different layout, physical layout, but it's the same amplifier except this one is using the EL34s and the LS-57s. Everything else is still the same. I haven't touched anything else. Still the same CD player. Everything, okay? Let's don't belabor it here. Let's turn this thing around. Lock her down good. Make sure everything's in focus. Make sure everything's still nice and quiet. Let's see. Yeah, I believe it's the same as it was a while ago. Okay, and here we go. Okay, now we're out in the shop, and this is a part that's probably going to surprise some of you. This is not the first time I've experienced this, so this is not an anomaly. But let me get over here and show you what I'm talking about. I definitely want to stay out of the front of the camera. Okay. See this one? See this scan right here? I'm scanning from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. And this scan right here is for one of the channels of the Acrosound. And you can see it starts out down here at about 0.1% THD at 20 hertz. It has a little lump right there, I don't know why. But it's actually very flat. It rises up to just a little bit over 1% THD. All of these are at 15 watts. All four of these scans you're going to see are exactly 15 watts. But you can see it does 20 hertz really good. It's up to about 1%, just a little bit over 1% at 20 kilohertz. Really quite nice. Okay, let's get that one out of the way. There's the other channel. I don't remember which one's left and which one's right. It doesn't really matter. This one seems to have a little lump in it, too. I can't explain that. I don't know if that's a software anomaly or what. I hope you're seeing these really good. This is actually quite important. Let me scope in on them a little bit better. Sorry, I got to move this camera around a bit. But it's really important you see these. Okay, that's the other channel. Let me move this one back up there just for a second. So you can see the first channel. Really, really, it does 20. It does a low frequency really well. Right? One channel, the other channel. Okay, now this is, these next two are of the UTC channels. And this is not an anomaly. I have found out that with one exception that I can recall, and that was when I built a W20 for a young lady back in Kentucky. It did 20 hertz really good, but these LS-57s and LS-61s won't do 20 hertz. They do 30 hertz pretty good, but look at how it does 20. It comes down, and it's nice and flat. And it's a little over one. It's over 1.5% out here THD at 20 kilohertz. These are the amplifiers you just got through listening to. That's one channel, and the other channel of that UTC transformer one is this one right here. There's one, and there's the other. They're virtually identical. This one is actually a little bit higher right there. See how it's a little bit closer? This one's a little bit lower, not significantly. This one ends up at about 1.7 or so percent. This one ends up about 0.1% lower. So as far as just hardcore scans of them, the UTC transformers, from what I have found out, and I am not knocking them, I like them a lot. I think they sound marvelous. But they don't do 20 hertz very well. They do 30 pretty well. See, 30 would be right there. Well, actually, it's not even all that great right there. 20, 30, 40, 50, does 50 hertz really well. That's where it really gets flat. Now, I'm not making this up, and I'm not trying to like one over the other, but this is what I get, and I just don't see any sense in me making them. There's the Acrosound transformers, me doing this, and you're going to see this. What do you think about those apples, huh? That's kind of interesting, isn't it? Now, I'm going to say this, too. I said I'd try not to throw too much of my opinion in there, but honestly, I think I like the highs. I think I like, there's something about the crispness and the cleanliness of the UTC transformers at the upper end that I think I like better. I mean, it's a very small nuance, but that's just my opinion. That's just my ears. It seems like the Acrosound transformers sound a little deeper at the low end. I think I perceive more bass, certainly not bassy, certainly not boomy or anything like that. I just feel like there's more power down there. Now, the Acrosound amplifier is a little bit more powerful. It'll do over 20, just over 25 watts, more like 27 watts when clipping comes in, and the UTC does 20. So for what it's worth, I thought it was fun and I wanted to do this, and I just didn't see any sense in going out here and setting all this stuff up and going through these, you know, all these measurements again with the equipment. All of you that have ever watched any of my videos know all this equipment, and we can scan it and whatever. I have actually added this one, this little oscilloscope with an FFT function to it, to my my arsenal of diagnostic tools out here, because I made a video sometime back and I talked a lot about those little RC circuits that are oftentimes in the front end and how they are there to suppress from the old days, the AM stations that used to be so prevalent, or it's also there to suppress some common, not uncommon, that may occur, 70 to 80, even 100 kilohertz type oscillations, and you can see it on this little FFT function on this scope, so much better than you can on the one that I run on the PC. The PC just really only goes to 20 kilohertz, but it does, the PC one just does a marvelous job at the low end and allows you to adjust the hum balance and what have you. And then of course, then there's this magnificent old, with a wire in the way here, magnificent old HP3580A. I brought it back out here because it's just such a jewel, something to play with all the time. Well, I don't think there's anything new. Oh, I got this. Look at this thing that I got at an estate sale for $12. I don't think it's ever been used. It's a Fluke meter scope, or whatever they call it. It's called the Fluke 9750 megahertz scope meter. Wow, really, really nice. Came with all the probes and everything. Yeah, you gotta go to an estate sale, see? Even came with all these probes. Actually, I got one probe plugged into it. So there you go. Hope everybody's doing well and staying safe and staying well and not having to deal with any of this, you know, any sickness from this COVID virus. Thanks for watching.